one of my key aims had when putting together this list was to make the content as varied as I possibly could. And so I ended up including some villain protagonists. These are usually thieves, assassins, or anti-heroines who happen to be as ruthless as the bad guys, even if their intentions are good. And Alexis Faraday, the main character in Momentum, certainly fits this description. And for those who prefer straight up female villains, we've also got one of those in this movie as well. From the very first scene of the film, it's clear that Alex is not a woman to be messed with. And even if you didn't read the blurb in advance, you know that when you've got bank robbers wearing farm disguising body armour and using voice modulators, that at least one of them's going to turn out to be a woman. But we still get a very good revelation, and that happens after one of the crew goes haywire.
Fuck you! You fucking shot me! Now you're gonna die!
Alex wastes no time in taking this nutcase out, and while he probably did have it coming, it establishes there was someone with a very vague moral compass. Olga Kurylenko has a thing for playing badass females with mysterious pasts. Another film in which she played a role like this was The Courier, where she was the title character who's tricked into delivering a cyanide dispersal device into a safe house as part of a plan to eliminate a witness. The main villain in this movie is a mob boss played by Gary Oldman, who does his best to look sinister in an eye patch, but prefers to direct things from very far away. And like any respectable mob boss, he's got corrupt cops on the payroll, and one of them is Interpol Agent Simmonds.
Cyanide. You fucking idiot. You just killed a high-value witness.
Despite Alicia Agneson appearing very high on the credits, she's seen off about 20 minutes into the movie, but she does get to look sufficiently badass in a gas mask before she's taken down by the courier. And after that we get another confrontation, but the shootout is over all too quickly. Despite the actress being quite far down the credits list and the character biting the dust before the finale, Michelle still features prominently on the poster. That's likely because professional hitwoman is far more interesting than the other players in this rather dull political thriller. Reporter John McVerter gets in over his head when investigating a businessman's murder, leading him to a muddled conspiracy and encounters with many recognisable B-movie actors. Plot elements go nowhere, especially some Algerians behind the assassination who don't feature at all in the final half, but they do hire Michelle to tie up loose ends and give us something to get excited about. This blonde woman is a cold professional who shoots and tortures people as if it's a perfectly normal thing to do. And after eliminating the assassins who've now outlived their usefulness and obtaining information from a minor character, it's time to confront John at his apartment.
All right, I won't bullshit you, my friend. Today is your last day on Earth. Now, I don't have control of that, but I do have control of the means. It can be an easy death or a hard one. The choice is yours.
The FBI are outside.
Well, they can't help you now. Have you seen the Sistine Chapel dome?
What?
You know, the ceiling, Michelangelo? There's this section, it's quite beautiful, where God extends his finger to man. His hand held out for life. You see, I'm discussing our relationship. Today, I'm a kind of God. offering you an easy death.
Extend your hand to me. Tell me where she is.
I don't know.
Fortunately, John has a secret hiding spot in his place for some reason, so his female guest is able to surprise Michelle.
Who are you? Answer me or I'll shoot you!
I was hired to kill you. Obviously, things have changed. I think we can work something out. I can help get you out of here.
This all leads to a rather disappointing climax with the assassin. Returning to momentum, the plot picks up when Alex and one of her crew members have a meeting in a hotel room, which is soon gatecrashed by a team of professional cleaners. Turns out that Alex didn't just steal diamonds from the bank vault, there was also a data drive, and the main baddie that wants to get hold of this is an unnamed senator, played by the guy who always seems to play politicians, and that's Morgan Freeman. And like Gary Oldman in The Courier, he prefers to direct things from a distance, and so his main proxy is a guy called Mr. Washington. And like the other members of his team, he uses code names based off ex-US presidents, and the female character is called Miss Clinton. And for the scene where the cleaners attempt to persuade Alex's partner to give up the data drive, we don't actually get to see much of Miss Clinton. It's mainly just shots of her leg. And Alex gets a very close view of the proceedings. And when she does retrieve the data drive, the pursuit of it then becomes the main focus of the plot. And what I did like about this film was the bad guys are shown to be intelligent. For instance, they have unloaded weapons in case they lose control of them, and they're not easily fooled by Alex's tricks during an attempt to escape. They also proved to be very difficult bad guys to kill, and that includes getting beaten up by Alex, knives thrown in the back, explosions. Fortunately, Alex proves to be equal to that challenge.
I don't negotiate. Offer's on the table, you have 5 seconds.
No more witty banter?
4, 3.
Bluffing doesn't suit you.
2.
Last chance.
I just don't think you're this cold.
1.
As for Miss Clinton, she's quite different to the usual henchwoman in some ways. She's not overly sadistic. We do see the occasional smile and snarky comment. But generally, she's more of a professional person, a cleaner like the rest of the team, who will keep her emotions in check.
He's right on the edge, so if you think he won't throw you in along with the garbage in the trunk, you're wrong.
And all this leads up to the climax, which takes place at an airport. And Mr. Washington has crippled Alex, but she still manages to turn the tables on them when she sets off a bomb and attracts the attention of airport security.
You trust me now?
Not now. Not ever.
Oh, fuck. Oh, shit.
Of course, we know that a bomb blast isn't enough to kill either of the bad guys. And I thought it a bit disappointing that after the big build-up of Alex and Miss Clinton, we didn't actually see them fight.
I think this should be our last face to face.
That tie wasn't doing you any favors. It had to be good for something.
Alex does get a better send-off when she tricks the police into shooting Mr. Washington.
Checkmate.
You really are the stuff of legends, aren't you?
Kind of like your tie.
But the final few minutes are all about setting up a sequel that's probably never going to happen because the film had very poor performance at the box office. And unfortunately, that's probably the last we're going to see of Alexis Faraday.